Good morning, it's Friday, March the 26th, and we've come to the end of the book of Ephesians. So I literally got the last four verses of the book of Ephesians. And yeah, first of all, I was like, oh, okay, I've got the last bit, the end. What's going to be in there that I can talk about? Because it's kind of like Paul signing off. But the more I looked at it and the more I prayed about it, there's quite a bit in these four verses. So we're going to start at verse 21. And we're on, yeah, so Ephesians 6, because there's only six chapters in Ephesians. Verse 21. And it says, so this is the final greetings of Paul. Tychicus, or Tychicus, or however you want to pronounce it, the dear brother and faithful servant in the Lord, will tell you everything, so that you may also know how I am and what I'm doing. I'm sending him to you for this very purpose, that you may know how we are and that he may encourage you. Peace to the brothers and sisters and love with faith from God the Father and the Lord Jesus Christ. Grace to all who love our Lord Jesus Christ with an undying love. So first of all, I was really interested in who this person Tychicus was. I haven't found out how to pronounce it correctly, but whatever his name was, he was a really close friend of Paul's. He's mentioned also in Colossians and 2 Timothy, I think it was, and he was kind of like Paul's right-hand man. Some people think that he may have even been his scribe, so Paul would have been dictating the letters to Tychicus. And then he was then given the job of taking them and delivering them and reading them out to the different churches. He was also tasked with encouraging the churches and saying how Paul's doing. He had a really important job of just sharing how Paul was getting on and encouraging the fellow brothers and sisters in all the different places that Paul was reaching them with the gospel. So the first thing I really wanted to touch on was the fact that Paul talks about him, but he talks about his dear brother and his faithful servant in the Lord. In Colossians 4:7, he also calls him a faithful minister. And he doesn't talk about his attributes, his successes, all these sort of things that perhaps the world looks at as success, but he talks more about his character as a faithful minister, a dear brother and a faithful servant in the Lord. So yeah, that shows also, Paul looks at those things and sees them as important, but that's what God looks at as well. We can do amazing achievements, but at the end of the day, God looks at the heart and who we are as a character and how we treat other people and how we love other people. It's all very well having loads of degrees, but if you haven't got love and if you don't think of others first, then that's not what God looks at. So that was the first thing I wanted to look at, but also the fact that Tychicus was living life in kind of, as I said, the second fiddle sort of thing to Paul, but he was diligently doing his work. And sometimes we're called to be the person in the background, the person delivering the letters, the person asked to do the bits of encouragement, rather than being the person on the stage. And that equally is important. And sometimes we're called to live a life that's faithfully, but hidden in that way, maybe hidden to other people, but is certainly not hidden to God. So what we do for the least of these, what we do to help others that man doesn't see, God sees absolutely everything. And as we spoke about last week, whatever we do, we're called to do it as if we're doing it for the Lord, because that's who we're doing it for. So again, we come back to that, serving wholeheartedly no matter what, whether you're doing something menial or on the stage, it doesn't matter, because at the end of the day we're serving God and that's what matters. And then come into the last couple of verses where Paul says, peace to the brothers and sisters and love with faith. Well, that was quite an interesting bit, love with faith. And we read in Hebrews 11:6, Paul says, and without faith it is impossible to please God, because anyone who comes to him must believe that he exists and that he rewards those who earnestly seek him. So it's having that love with faith to please God. And yeah, it's just coming into land with this this encouragement, this this beautiful way of wrapping up the whole of this pocket rocket of a book. It's only six chapters, but what is in here is just, I love Ephesians. You know, starting out starting out with, you know, Paul wanting to enlighten the hearts of those in Ephesus, and we've got instructions for Christian living, we've got instructions for children, for parents, and then as we read, I think it was the week before last, about being awoken, not wandering around sort of dazed and confused, but coming to God and asking him to open the eyes of our hearts to realize that there's more to life than this, there's more going on. You know, there is a spiritual realm, and that's exciting. But also Paul talked about the fact that we don't fight with weapons on earth. It's, you know, we're fighting things in the heavenly realms, in the spiritual realms, and our weapons are weapons of prayer and shields of faith. So it's recognizing that that is so important as well. And I love the fact that yes, we need to have faith to please God, but as we know from the beginning of this chapter, when Paul talks about the armor of God, that is the shield of faith that we hold up to quench the arrows that the enemy will chuck at us. So yeah, it's just that encouragement at the end to have this faith as well as love for God, and to keep putting that armor on. I know I'm stealing from a couple of weeks ago, but I think that's so important every day to keep putting that armor on, keep being encouraged, keep having good motives, keep doing whatever God asks you to do for his glory. Have a lovely day. Bye.